Today we have the class 7th physics, and chapter number 2 we have already covered about the force and the pressure, and already in the previous class we have already covered about the force and pressure and motion. In this chapter we have already covered the different types of motion, types of motions we have already covered, and today we have to study chapter number unit 2, that is the speed and velocity. That is speed and velocity. Topic is speed and velocity. Speed and velocity. Okay. What is speed? What is the definition of speed? Today in the today class, we have to study about the following things. What is the definition of speed? What are the kinds of different types of speeds are there? Uniform speed, non-uniform speed, and velocity. What is the definition of velocity? What is the SI unit of velocity? And what are the different uniform velocity? What are the example of uniform velocity? What are the example of non-uniform velocity? Okay. Then after we have to start about the what is the definition of mass? What is the definition of weight? These things we have to cover today. Okay. What are the things we have to read? First of all, what is the definition of speed? And what is the definition of velocity? We have to study about the velocity also. Third thing is that we have to study about the mass. Fourth thing is that we have to study about the weight. How can you find out the weight of a body? How can you find out the mass of a body? Okay. So first of all, you have to study about the speed. What is the definition of speed? Okay. Students, in the previous class, I've already studied. You have already know about the speed. What is the definition of speed? You have already know about the what is the definition of speed? Okay. Who can define what is the definition of speed? Raise your hand. Yes. So definition of speed says that the rate of change of motion, the rate of change of motion is called as the speed. The rate of change of motion is called as the speed. That is the definition of speed. Is the rate of change of motion is called as the speed. Speed can be defined as the rate of change of motion is called as the speed. Speed is also having some definition as distance covered by a body, distance upon time taken, distance covered by the object upon time taken. Okay, this is the numerical definition and mathematical definition, and in theoretically you can say that speed is the rate of change of motion. Speed is the rate of change of motion, that is called as the speed. Okay. Speed can be defined as the rate of change of motion is called as the speed. And in mathematical you can write a distance covered by the object divided by time taken. Distance covered by the object divided by time taken. That is called as the speed. If you consider S is the distance covered by a body. If you consider that S is the, if you consider speed can be defined as, if you consider S, small s you can take, S is the distance covered by a body, and the small t is the time taken. Small t is the time taken by the object to complete that particular distance. That means speed can be also defined as S upon t. S upon t means S is the distance covered by the particular object and t is the time taken. Okay. That means you can also define the speed mathematically as this speed equal to distance upon time. That means S upon t. Okay. What this is the mathematical or numerical definition of speed. Got it? Then comes to what is the unit of speed? What is the unit of speed? What is the unit of speed? Speed can, you can define the speed as the rate of change of motion is called as the speed, and the speed is also can be defined as the distance divided by time taken. The what are the distance that is covered by the body divided by time taken to complete that particular distance. Okay, that means then comes to unit of speed. What is the unit of speed? As you all know that speed equal to distance upon time, time taken. Okay, that means distance having the unit. What is the unit of distance? Distance is having the unit meter. SI unit is meter. Okay, and time taken means SI unit is second. That means meter per second. You can write the speed. The unit of speed is meter per second in SI unit. SI unit you can take meter per second. That is the unit of speed. And in CGS unit, in smaller unit, you can say CGS unit. In CGS unit, it has the unit centimeter per second. Okay, meter can be converted into centimeter. In the smaller unit, you can write meter in place of meter. You can write centimeter. Centimeter per second. This is the CGS unit of speed, and this is the SI unit of speed. Okay, these are the definition. I have already explained about the definition. What is the definition of speed, and what is the mathematical definition, as well as the what is the unit of speed, SI unit, as well as the CGS unit. We have covered the speed. What is the definition? We have already covered the speed definition. Okay, then comes to what are the kind of speeds are there? What are the kinds of speed? What are the kinds of speed? What are the types of speeds are there? What are the different types of speeds are there? First one is uniform speed. Second one is non-uniform speed. First one is uniform speed. Uniform speed. Second one is non-uniform speed. Speed. Okay, first one is uniform speed, second one is non-uniform speed. Okay, one attendance link is provided to you by the school. You can click the attendance link and get, you can give your attendance. Okay, I have already seen. Okay, that means the speed can be divided into two types. One is uniform speed, second one is non-uniform speed. And what is the definition of uniform speed, and how can you define the uniform speed? You can write down also what is the definition of uniform speed. When a body covers equal distance with equal interval of time, when a object or body cover equal distance with equal interval of time, then you can call it as uniform speed. Okay, you can write the definition as when a object or a body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, then it is called as the uniform speed. Let us take an example. How can you find out the uniform speed? I have already in the previous class already have discovered the uniform speed. Uniform speed is when a train is traveling the speed of 90 km per hour. When a train is traveling at the speed of 90 km per hour, that means it is a uniform speed, and it is continuously moving at the speed of 90 km per hour. That means it is a, it has the uniform speed. And when his car is moving constantly at a speed of 40 kilometers per hour, 50 kilometers per hour, that means the car is having a constant speed or uniform speed. That means you can call it as a uniform speed. Okay. Then comes to, these are the examples of uniform speed. You can take out any body. For any body moves with a constant speed, that means it's not changing its speed. Its speed is constant. That means it is called as the uniform speed. Okay, then comes to non-uniform. Second one is non-uniform speed. Second one is non-uniform speed. What is the definition of non-uniform speed? Definition of non-uniform, you can write in your copy also. Definition of non-uniform speed, or it also may be called as the variable speed also. It also may be called as the variable speed. Okay, how can you define this? When a body covers unequal distance with equal interval of time, when a body covers unequal distance, unequal means not the same distance, unequal distance with equal interval of time. That means when a body covers different types of distance in the same interval of time, equal interval of time, that means that is called as a non-uniform speed. Okay. When a body covers unequal distance with equal interval of time, I'm again repeating also, when a body covers unequal distance with equal interval of time, that means this is called as the non-uniform speed. You can take an example. You can see the figure number 2.20. You can see the, in your book, physics book, the page number 36, page number 36, you can see the figure number 2.20. That is given example of non-uniform speed. That means the body is moving with a different speed. That means first it is moving the 40 kilometer per hour. Then it is next hour it is moving in the speed of 20 kilometer per hour. The next hour it is moving in the speed of 30 kilometers per hour. That means the body is moving the different speeds. Okay. That means it covers unequal distance. Unequal distance with equal interval of time. The time interval is 1 hour, but the distance is different. First 40 kilometers it is moving in the 1 hour. Second in 1 hour it is moving in the 20 kilometers per hour. The third 1 hour it is covering a distance of 30 kilometers. That means the three different distance it is covering in the different hour. Okay. That means this is called as a non-uniform speed or variable. We can call it as a variable speed. When the speed is varying, that means that is called as a variable speed. Okay. These are the definition I have already explained, as well as I have already explained about the unit. What are the kinds of speed? Uniform. First one is the uniform speed, and second one is the non-uniform speed. First one is the uniform speed, and second one is the non-uniform speed. Okay. Got it? What is the definition of uniform speed? What is the definition of non-uniform speed? And also I have given examples of both uniform as well as the non-uniform. Okay. Then comes to what is the definition of average speed? How can you find out the average speed? How can you find out average speed? What is the definition of average speed? You can write down the definition as the average distance covered by a moving body. The average distance covered by a moving body per unit time when the body is moving with a different variable speed, that is called as the average speed. That means when a body is moving with a different speed, when the body is moving with a different speed, and if you add the total distance, upon the total time taken to cover the particular distance is called as the average speed. You can write out mathematically as you can write down average speed equal to total distance covered divided by time taken to complete the distance. Okay, that means the total distance covered divided by total time taken to complete that particular distance is called as the average speed. If you have the different speeds are there, if a vehicle is moving the 20 kilometer per hour, next 1 hour it is moving with the 30 kilometer per hour, next 1 hour it is moving with the 40 kilometer per hour, you can add the total distance. What is the distance that is covered? The 3 hour divided by time taken is 3 hour. That means you can get the average speed as particular by this formula. Okay. What the formula you have? You can have the formula as total distance covered by total time taken to complete that particular distance is called as the average speed. You can take an example as if a body is covering a distance of 40 kilometer per hour in the first half 1 hour, it is covering a distance of 40 kilometer. Then the next 1 hour it is covering a distance of 30 kilometer per hour. The next one hour it is covering a distance of 20 kilometer per hour. Okay, that means first 1 hour it is covering a distance of 40 kilometer. Second 1 hour it is covering a distance of 30 kilometer, and the third 1 hour it is covering a distance of 20 kilometer. That means three different variable speeds are there, but you have to find out the what is the average speed and the time taken is how can you what the time taken already you know average speed equal to total distance how much distance it is covering. First is 40 kilometer per hour. Second one is 30 kilometer. third one is 20 km. That means 40 average speed equal to 40 km plus 20 plus 30 km plus 20 divided by total time taken. Total taken 3 hours. That means 40 plus 30, 70, 20, 90, 90 km per 3. That means that is 30 km per hour. It is having the average speed of 30 km per hour. That is the average speed. You can get the average speed by adding the sum of the total different distance divided by total time taken. Okay. That is the, you can get the definition as well as the mathematical statement of average speed. Then comes to velocity. What is the definition of velocity? Okay. We have covered the speed. What is the definition of speed? And what is the kinds of speeds are there? What are the types of speeds are there? And what is the definition of average speed also we have covered. Okay. Then comes to what is the definition of velocity? What is the definition of velocity? You can write down. The velocity is a definition having the rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement is called as the velocity. Okay. Rate of change of displacement is called as the velocity. And also you can write down the definition as velocity is the rate of change of motion in a specified direction. In a specified direction, the rate of change of motion is also called as the velocity. Velocity is also called as the, you can write down the rate of change of displacement. You can write down the rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement is called velocity. Okay. You can write, this is also one definition. Second definition you can write down. It is the rate of change of motion with a specified direction. Okay, rate of change of motion with a specified direction. Rate of change of motion with a specified direction, that is also termed as a velocity. Velocity means it is the speed with a particular direction. If you having the speed and also you have the direction, which direction speed is there, that means you can get the velocity. Velocity you can define as the rate of change of displacement is called as the rate of change of displacement is called as the velocity. Okay. And as we cover the speed, having the different kinds of types of speeds are there, uniform speed, non-uniform speed. The same procedure, velocity, you also having the different kinds. That means the first one is uniform velocity. First of all, we have to cover the uniform velocity. What is the definition of uniform velocity? Second one is non-uniform velocity. Non-uniform velocity. Okay. First one is uniform velocity and second one is non-uniform velocity. Speed and velocity having the same magnitude, but having the in the velocity case, you can have only find out the specified direction. Specified direction means velocity is a it can define as the rate of change of displacement. Displacement, what is the displacement? A distance with a specified direction is called as a displacement. If you're covering a distance with a specified direction, particular direction in the west direction, that means you can get the displacement. That means in the velocity case, you can having the speed with a particular direction also. Okay. And when you are talking about the uniform velocity, first one is the uniform velocity. What is the definition of uniform velocity? You can write down the definition of uniform velocity is when the body covers equal distance with equal interval of time. When the body covers equal distance with equal interval of time with a specified direction. Okay. That means I'm again repeating that when a body covers equal distance with equal interval of time with a specified direction, then it is called as the uniform velocity. Okay. You can write down the definition. when a body covers equal distance with equal interval of time with a specified particular direction. Specified means a particular direction, that means it is called as a uniform, that is called as a uniform velocity. Okay. Now you can see the figure number 2.21 in your textbook, page number 38, page number 38. You can see the figure number 2.21. You can have in the uniform speed. When a body is covering the first 1 second, it is covering the distance of 5 meter, and second time it is covering a distance of 5 meter also. On the third 1 second, it is covering a distance of 5 meter. That means it is continuously with a uniform speed. Uniform speed also it is continuously and having a particular direction. That means its direction is towards the east direction. Its direction is towards the east direction. That means in this particular case, you can say that the body is a uniform speed. Body is a in the uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means if the speed is uniform and it has some specified direction, it has some particular direction. In these two conditions, you have to satisfy. First of all is the speed should be uniform. The two conditions needed for the uniform velocity, the speed should be uniform. Second one is direction is, it will have some specified direction. Specified or particular direction. If the two conditions are satisfied, then you can call it as a uniform velocity. Okay. And then comes to what is a non-uniform velocity? What is the non-uniform velocity or variable velocity? You can call it as a variable velocity, or you can term as a non-uniform velocity. What is non-uniform velocity? Same definition as a speed. Non-uniform speed, you have already known the definition. What is non-uniform speed? If a body covers unequal distance with equal interval of time, here also the same cases, that is the variable velocity. What the definition of variable velocity? It can be defined as when a body covers unequal distance, with equal interval of time. When a body covers unequal distance with an equal interval of time with a specified direction, then it is called as the non-uniform velocity. Non-uniform means if a body covers unequal, same as a non-uniform speed also, but the one thing is different. That means it's in a particular specified direction you have to mention. Okay, you have to mention the specified direction. That means when a body covers unequal distance with equal interval of time with a specified direction, then it is said to be called as the variable velocity. You can see the example number 2.23. You can see the figure number 2.23, that is in the book page number 38. Okay, that is a body is covering a speed of non-uniform speed. That means it is covering a first 1 second. It is covering a distance of 3 meter. Okay, just see the book. In the first second, it is covering a distance of 3 meter. Second, it is covering a distance of 4 meter. On third second, it is covering a distance of 2 meter. And a fourth second, it is covering a distance of 4 meter. That means the different types of distance it is covering. With a 1 second, time is 1 second, but distance what is covering, that is a different. If the distance covering by the body is different with respect to time and it is a particular direction is towards the east direction is given, that means that is called as a non-uniform velocity, or you can call it as a variable velocity. Variable means it is varying with respect to time. Okay. Then comes to what is the definition of average velocity. Then comes to how can you find the average velocity? If a body is moving with equal distance, equal interval of time, how can you find out the average velocity? Average velocity. What is the definition of average velocity? You can write down the definition as the average displacement of a body per unit time. एवरेज डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ ए बॉडी फॉर यूनिट टाइम व्हेन ए बॉडी इज एक्चुअली मूविंग विथ अ वेरिएबल वेलोसिटी. व्हेन द बॉडी इज मूविंग विथ अ वेरिएबल वेलोसिटी यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द एवरेज डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ ए बॉडी फॉर यूनिट टाइम दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द एवरेज वेलोसिटी. ओके, यू कैन राइट डाउन द डेफिनेशन एज द एवरेज डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ ए बॉडी फॉर यूनिट टाइम. ओके, व्हेन द एवरेज डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ ए बॉडी फॉर यूनिट टाइम when the body is actually moving with a variable velocity, when the body is moving with a different types of velocity, what is the average displacement that you are finding? That is called for time taken is called as the average velocity. Okay, you take an example. You can take an example of if a body is covering a distance of you can see the figure number 2.23 also, that above, in this particular case the body is with a variable speed, that means a different speeds are there. Figure number 2.3, just look the figure number 2.3, it is the covering a distance of first 1 second, it is covering 3 meter distance, then covering 4 meter distance, different distance it is covering. Okay, and how can you find out the average velocity? That means average velocity, you can write down the definition as total displacement, not total distance, total displacement upon total time taken. Total displacement upon total time taken, that is you can call as the average velocity. Average velocity you can find out mathematically by the total displacement upon total time taken. Total displacement upon total time taken, you can term it as the average velocity. In this particular case, example number 2.23, you can see that the total displacement, how can you find the total displacement? Total the first, in the first 1 second, it is covering 3 meter, then 4 meter, then 2 meter, then 4 meter. 3 plus 4, 3 meter plus 4 meter plus 2 meter plus 4 meter. Okay, that means 3, 4, 7, 3, 4 meter, then 2 meter, then 4 meter. Okay, 3 plus 7, 7 to 9, 9, 4, 13. That means it is covering a distance of 13 meter in 4 second. Okay, 13 meter upon 4 second. That means you can find out 3.25 meter per second. Meter per second is the SI unit of the velocity. You can tell me speed and velocity having the same unit, having the same unit. But speed and velocity having the same unit, that means you can call as in a SI unit you can write meter per second. In CGS unit, you can the speed and velocity having the same, that means as meter per second and centimeter per second. And in higher unit also you can write kilometer per hour. Okay, kilometer per hour is a higher unit of the speed as well as the velocity. Okay, and one condition is that it is possible to have a body average velocity as zero. Average velocity of a body may be zero also, but average speed will not be zero. Okay, average speed will not be zero, but average velocity of a body can be zero. These are the definition we have already covered. Average velocity of a body, If a boy is moving from his home to the school and comes back to this home also, that means total distance covered is zero. Total displacement is zero. Total distance it is covering, that means it is covering a distance of 20 meter from his home to the school. It is covering a distance of 20 meter and return back to its home also 20 meter. That means 40 meter distance it is covering. But displacement is zero. Displacement, why the displacement zero? That means it is going in the forward direction and coming in the backward direction. If the direction is opposite, that even displacement is zero. And that means total displacement is zero, then divided by time. Time taken is 1 hour in when he is moving from the home to school, it is moving, the time is 1 hour, and is coming when the coming time is also 1. That means it is covering a displacement is 0 upon time. That means you can write down also average velocity as 0. Okay, then these are the how can you find out the average velocity, average speed as a zero? Okay. Then comes to what is the definition of mass and what is the definition of weight? What is the definition of mass and what is the definition of weight? You have already know about the what are the things we have covered today. Today we have covered the different types of definition, like what is the definition of speed, what is the definition of velocity, what are the different types of speed. We have already know what are the kinds of speeds are there and what are the kinds of velocity. What are the kinds of velocity we have already covered. Okay. Then comes to what is the definition of mass. What is the definition of mass? Mass, you can define the mass as the amount of matter contained inside a body. The amount of matter, what are the amount of matter that is contained inside a body, that is called as the mass. Contained as the mass of a particular body. Okay. Mass cannot be changed. Mass is always constant in everywhere. Okay. That means mass is the amount of matter contained inside a body. If a body having some mass, that means 5 kg, that means this is the 5 kg is the mass of a particular object. You can say that this much amount of matter is contained inside the particular body. That means 5 kg. Okay. It is a constant quantity. It does not change with respect to time or position or location. It does not change with respect to position, location. You cannot change the mass. Mass is a constant quantity. You can measure the mass of a particular object by physical valence. Physical valence is the instrument by which you can measure the mass of a particular object. Physical valence, you can see the figure number 2.24. Figure number 2.34, this is the, it is showing that the how the physical balance is constructed. Physical balance, how it is made, it is just showing in the figure. Now you can see in the page number 39, physical balance, it is showing in the page number 39. Okay. And it is also called as the beam balance also. It is also called as the beam balance. Physical balance as well as it is also called as the beam balance. Okay. The SI unit of mass. What is the SI unit of mass? The SI unit of mass is kilogram, kg. The SI unit of mass is kilogram, that means kg. Okay. And in CGS unit, you can term as a gram. Even CGS unit, you can term as a gram also. The SI unit, you can take the mass. The SI unit of mass is kg. And in CGS, you can term as a gram. Okay. What are the multiples? Some multiple of mass are there. The multiple of mass is 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram, and 100 kilogram equal to 1 quintal, and 1000 kilogram, that means 10 quintal equal to 1 ton. You can talk the higher terms of multiples of mass are there. What are the sum multiple of mass are there? Sum multiple means 1000 milligram equal to 1 gram. 1000 milligram. Just listen. 1000 milligram equal to 1 gram, and 1000 gram also, 1 kilogram also, you already know the mathematics also. Okay. Then comes to, this is the definition of mass we have covered. What is the definition of mass? The amount of matter contained inside a body is called the mass. The SI unit of mass is kilogram. This much we have covered. Then comes to weight. Then comes to, what is the definition of weight? Weight can be defined as, weight is the force with which the earth pushes the body towards its center. Weight can be defined. It is a type of force which is acting by the center of the earth. Weight is a force with which the earth pulls the body towards the center. Towards the center. When the earth is pulling some body towards the center, that means that is the force. What are the force that is acting? That is called as the weight. That is called as the weight. Okay. Weight is having the SI unit kilogram force. That means you can write kilogram force to the gravitational unit, it is the term as the kilogram force, and in CGS you can write the gram force. Okay, in CGS you can write the gram force, and in the SI unit, in SI means standard international system of unit, the weight is having the weight is, as weight is also type of force, weight is the SI unit. The SI unit, the weight is having the unit as Newton. as the force is having the unit newton, so SI unit of weight is also newton. Okay, and the CGS unit you can term as a dyne. CGS unit you can term the unit of weight is dyne. Okay. Then comes to what are the difference? The difference of mass and weight. What the difference between mass and weight? There are five differences are there. You have to learn this particular difference. What are the differences are there? First is the definition of mass. What is the definition of mass? The amount of matter contained inside a body is called the mass. The amount of matter contained inside a body is called the mass. And weight. What is the definition of weight? Weight is can be defined as what is a force with which the earth attracts the body towards its center. Weight is a type of force which is which the earth attracts the body towards its center, that is called as the weight. Then comes to mass is a constant quantity. It cannot be varied with respect to different place. It cannot be varied, but weight of a body is a variable quantity. It changes with respect to the different in acceleration due to the gravity of earth. In a different position of the earth, the weight of a body can be changed. Okay, weight of a moon can be also changed. Okay, if a body having the mass in the earth surface, if you take the body in towards the in the moon, the weight of a body can be changed also. The mass of a body, we can found the help of the physical balance. With the help of the physical balance, we can measure the mass. We can by the help of physical balance, we can measure the mass. Okay, but the weight can of a body can be found with the help of a spring balance. With the help of a spring balance, weight of a body can be found. Okay, by the physical balance, weight of a mass of a body can be found, and weight of a body can be found the physical balance. Sorry, spring balance, that is called the spring. SPRI, the spring balance. Okay, fourth and fifth point is the SI unit of mass is kg. The SI unit of mass is kg, and the SI unit of weight is newton. Okay, that can be termed as capital N. The mass of a body can never be zero. If a body having the mass, that cannot be never be zero. Okay, but the weight of a body can be zero if there is the gravity is zero. Gravity means small g. Small, if the small g will be zero, then the weight of a body can be zero. Okay, these are the five difference that we have got from the mass and weight. Okay. If you have some doubt in this particular topic, mass, weight, speed, velocity, you can raise your hand. Okay. Seventh C, Aradhana. Yes.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. What do you have the doubt?
Sir, please explain one more time variable velocity and average velocity.
Variable velocity. Variable velocity means if a body covers unequal distance, if a body covers unequal distance with respect to the equal interval of time with a specified direction, if a body covers unequal distance means a different types of distance. That means if the distance is like this, if the first, in the first 1 second, if a body covers 3 meters, the next 1 second is body cover the 4th meter, then next 1 second cover the 5 meters. That means a different speed the body is covering. Okay, the different distance the body is covering with respect to same time. That means you can find out the where the body is having the variable speed. The body is having the variable speed. Okay, sorry, variable velocity. And if a body having the variable velocity, that means it is having the specified direction. For the specified direction, the variable velocity is mentioned. Okay, and average velocity. Average velocity means it is the you can define the average velocity as total displacement upon total time. Total displacement upon total time. You can add the particular displacement and 3 meter, 4 meter, and 5 meter, 5, 4, 9, and 12 meter. Okay, you have the order displacement, and the time is 1 second. That means 3 seconds of the time. That means total displacement upon total time. That you can got the, that means the total 12 upon 3. That means 4 meter per second. That means the average velocity. Yes, got it.
Yes, sir.
Next, Abhishek Yadav. Yes.
Sir, please explain the speed.
Speed. What is the definition of speed? Speed can be defined as the distance covered by a body with respect to time is called as the speed. The distance covered by a body with respect to time is called as the speed. Speed having the SI unit meter per second. Okay, in CGS you can write the centimeter per second. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Then Satyam Pandey.